Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. Joining me today is Jay Roberts, CEO at Vyant Bio. Jay, it's good to see you. How are you today?
It's good to see you, Christina. Very well. Thank you.
Jay, in March of this year, Stemonix closed its merger with Cancer Genetics, where you were its CEO. The combined group was then rebranded to be named Vyant Bio. Talk to us more about this rebranding, how the combined companies create a new path forward for innovation.
Yeah, so we brought together what was CGIX together with Stemonix, and so as we merged the two companies, you know, Stemonix, interesting company that had built unique disease models with a focus in neurology primarily, and we were really interested from as we were bringing the two companies together to be able to marry together sort of this deep biology disease modeling system that Stemonix had developed, and combining that with really rich data analytics and bioanalytics capabilities, because we think the use of data science together with biology, and that in combination with what the CGIX side brought together, which was in vivo testing, so preclinical screening and testing, you know, which was really the pathway to the regulatory approval process for drug development, and so combining these two companies give us, which is a really, we think, unique strategy focused on bringing in silico, so complex computer modeling together with in vitro across what we believe to be key is across human cell-based assays and then in vivo testing and regulatory, give us a platform to rapidly iterate and identify novel therapeutic candidates.
And I think it's really important to touch on the fact that the company recently reported earnings. So can you just touch on Vyant's second quarter results and its cash runway?
Yeah. So, you know, I think the first thing I'd like to point out is that, you know, this was our first full quarter together post the merger. So, you know, this first quarter was spent, you know, very focused on integration, focused on our strategic plan, focused on progressing, I think, you know, the sort of this combination of bringing our cultures together. And we achieved an awful lot in you know, just 90 days. And, you know, so the good news would be we ended the quarter with $26.5 million in cash. And that's a runway, given our current cash burn, to bring us out 18 to 24 months. And, you know, we're really investing heavily in our research and development programs, and our interest is to focus on neurological and diseases in oncology. And, you know, with that, we are investing in building unique disease models. And, you know, this comes back to the Stemonix platform and, you know, having developed, you know, what we think is really sort of market leading capabilities of functional three-dimensional organoids. And so we're investing heavily there. That gives us the insights necessary to be able to identify both novel biological targets as well as novel compounds. We do that in an iterative fashion, and that allows us to be able to make de-risked decisions and to accelerate. And that leaves us with a very capital efficient drug discovery platform that, again, as we focus in a couple of areas, you know, we think allows us to progress forward pretty quickly. You know, that being said, we do have a services business and reported results there the other day. And, you know, on a pro forma basis between the two companies, we did see 26% plus growth rates on top line. We think that the services business is sort of fundamentally allowing us to build out some of our R&D capabilities. So we think that it's an important component. But as we think about the, sort of the focus for the company going forward, you know, truly it is to identify novel, you know, biological targets, novel therapeutics, and to bring those assets forward in partnership with pharma and biotech.
Yeah, tell us a bit more about what your drug development strategy looks like moving ahead. I know that the group recently formed a collaboration announced just today with a group called Cyclica.
Yeah, let me address a couple of those. So Stemonix had previously entered into a joint venture agreement with a private company called Atomwise, and you know, that relationship, which is really was key to our strategy, allowing us to leverage an ability using artificial intelligence systems or machine learning systems to screen down from, you know, what starts as billions of potential candidates, drug candidates. And then, you know, that screening process allows us to then take a subset of what we think to be potentially novel compounds into our platform, and then do screening across human-derived cells, and then ultimately into in vivo and preclinical testing. So we're creating what we think are unique but important collaborations with key partners. You mentioned Cyclica. We announced that one today. Really important relationship. So the Atomwise program is focused on Rett syndrome, so very specific in that neurodevelopmental disease. The arrangement that we had put together today with Cyclica is focusing on CDKL5, which is a neurodegenerative disease found in infants. And similarly, they'll be helping us to screen down potential targets, both on the biological side as well as drug candidates, and doing that very efficiently, and then bringing those targets into our capabilities to then run across across our platforms, and then ultimately. And so as we think about the plan, it's really to, you know, kind of go from identification of targets to IND. And so there's a lot of discovery activities that fit in between that, for which we're, you know, we're proficient in continuing to, you know, develop our capability sets there. And then I think the third one, which we announced a couple of months ago, we entered into a collaboration with two other private companies called Ordeus and Solaria, to what we think are leading companies in their field, but also bringing artificial intelligence and cell-based, human cell-based assays for us to be able to do the design of, you know, what will be novel proteins as therapeutics. So bringing us, you know, forward in a biologic that we think we can progress through the iteration process and ultimately get a therapeutic. And in that particular case, we're focused on a target called HER2 positive, which obviously is a reasonably well-known target. And so far from, you know, from all these programs, we're seeing, you know, very good progress, and we're very, very, very happy about the relationships.
Yeah. So for existing investors, maybe investors new to the story, what exactly should they be paying attention to in terms of your key assets for the second half of the year?
Yeah. So, you know, we expect a couple of things. One is the ongoing validation of our disease platforms. And we think that that's important, obviously, from a, you know, from an integrity of the data perspective, and also in terms of the insights that we're gaining while we're moving through the drug discovery sort of life cycle. We, you know, again, as we think about the Atomwise relationship, we've made incredibly good progress in the identification of a novel therapeutic for Rett syndrome. So I think that's a place to pay attention. I think, you know, soon after that, we expect a novel biological targets and compounds from our relationship with Ordeus and Solaria in HER2 positive. And then what we announced today with Cyclica, you know, our disease model is, you know, essentially at commercial level. And so this now relationship allows us to start the screening process and for us to be able to then identify, you know, what we think will be important therapeutics as we move into 2022. And so our, you know, we've got these programs. I will say it's, again, highly focused for us in neurology and oncology. And those are the two places where we've got deep expertise across our teams. And, you know, between, you know, these the combined companies, you know, I think we've got certainly more than 30 or 35 years in, you know, combined between these two disease areas. So I'm very excited about the future. It's been a great first, you know, first quarter combined, and we're looking forward to a great second half of the year.
Yeah, we're excited to follow the story here. Jay, thanks so much.
Thank you very much, Christine. Good to see you.